All right, kia ora everyone. It's Nathan Rose here in beautiful Auckland, New Zealand. Really excited to take you through this demo in Dynamics Customer Service and Power Automate. Now, I realize this is a bit off brand for me. We're moving away from the world of Power FX and low code plugins, but what I've got to show you is super exciting. It's also a testament to the power of community. In the MVP world, we're always talking about success powered by community. And last night, Ben Clist dropped an epic comment on my LinkedIn post showing me how to solve this exact problem. And so Ben, thanks so much, man. Epic comment. This video is dedicated to you. All right, so what are we trying to solve? Well, in Dynamics Customer Service, when we're configuring service level agreements or SLAs, we have the ability to set business hours and public holidays. Basically, when we expect the SLA to compute, such as Monday to Friday, 9 to 5, and when we don't expect it to compute, Saturday or Christmas Day or New Year's Day, times when people aren't supposed to be working. And so what we want to be able to do is automatically set those holidays up in the calendar in Dynamics. For those of you who have worked with customer service for a while, you may be used to once a year having to go in and manually set up the holidays for the coming year. And this is a silly problem to have. We have tools in the Power Platform that can automate these types of things, meaning we don't have to think about it, it just happens. So let me go ahead and share my screen and let's get into this. All right, so as you can see here in Dynamics Service, we've got a calendar with public holidays that can be added. And so we get a name and a start and an end date, and there's a duration that's computed. So when I tried to do this yesterday in Power Automate, I got a failure message. Basically, this table in Dataverse, which is called Holiday Wrapper behind the scenes, doesn't let you use traditional create methods in Power Automate to go and create these. Now, this drove me crazy because this is a really silly problem to have. I want to be able to automatically create these once a year. And again, in a testament to community, Ben dropped an epic comment in my LinkedIn post saying that there is an endpoint called Save Holiday. You just need to post to it. And he even gave me the JSON so that I could go ahead and try this out. So let's take a look at how this works. And to do that, we're going to pop over to Power Automate. So let me just get rid of that. All right. Here is my cloud flow in Power Automate. And so what we're going to do is we're going to trigger this manually. Now in production, you would have this set up to run on a schedule, say once a year, but we're going to trigger this manually. Once we do that, we're going to go and we're going to grab our public holidays. In this case, we're going to get them for New Zealand and I want to get them for next year. So I'm going to use some functions to basically say, get the first part of UTC a year from now. So that should just give me the year, i.e. 2025. Once I've done that and pulled these public holidays down, I need to filter them. So here in New Zealand and in many other places around the world, we've got two types of holidays. We have holidays that apply to everyone, and then we have holidays that only apply to people in certain regions, i.e. in Auckland or Wellington. And so what I want to do is I want to filter this array to get the holidays that apply to everyone, and in this case, just the holiday that applies to Auckland. Now I'm using the name. There is a subarray called counties, and that's the preferred way to do it, although I was struggling a bit. If you look at James Williams' post, he's had some success using contains with that subarray, but I just need to get the one for Auckland. So I'm going to cheat a little bit and just use the name. Once I've filtered my array, I need to parse out that JSON. That means that all these individual items that I need, so things like the name and the date, is going to be available to me when I go and start creating this row in Dataverse. Now, one more thing I need to do before I get started is I need to create an actual date and timestamp. You see, my API is going to return a date only, but Dataverse is going to require a date time value. So I'm just going to use this format date time function, and that's going to take my date and put it into date and time. And now we're ready to go ahead and post to Dataverse. Now you can see we're using the HTTP connector instead of the standard Dataverse connector. And in order to do that, there's some stuff we're going to have to do behind the scenes first. Now, this works pretty much the same way the Dataverse connector would work that you're used to. The only thing is Dataverse takes care of things like authentication and your body and all of that for you. We've got to go and set that. But once you know how to do it, it's not too bad. So firstly, before we do this, we're actually going to have to set up an application user in Azure. Now, I'm not going to go into the detail of how to do this. There's plenty of tutorials, but we do have to go into Azure and we've got to set up an application user. Once we've done that, an application registration in Azure. Once we've done that, we can now set up an application user in the Power Platform Admin Center. That application user is going to let us use this post method to write to Dataverse. So we're going to use our organization URL, so the same one you would use for any other type of OData request when you're working with Dataverse. You're just going to append it with the save holiday. So that's what you want. That's the endpoint that you want. We're then going to put in this JSON body that Ben was so kind to provide us with. So Ben, thanks again for this. Now, firstly, we need to bind this to a calendar. I'm going to use a environment variable to do this. There are a number of ways you could do it. You could list rows, you could get a row by ID. But since it's kind of a known quantity, to me, it just makes the most sense to use an environment variable, and that saves us having to do another request to Dataverse. Next, we're just going to set some columns based on our API response. So we grab the name that's coming back from the API. We're going to take the start date that we've formatted here, and then the scheduled end. What we need to do is we need to add a day so that we get this duration column calculated properly. So for the example of Christmas Day, our output here, our date here, start date is going to be 25 December, and our end date is going to be 26 December. So I'm just going to add a day to this date. Once I've done that, I'm ready to configure my authentication. Now, this is a bit that can get a little tricky, so let me take you through this. It's actually not too hard once you've wrapped your head around it. So we're going to use Active Directory OAuth. That's the authentication method that you want to use. For authority, you're going to put in login.windows.net. Then for tenant, you're going to put in this tenant ID from your application registration in Azure. For the audience, you're going to put in the first part of your Dynamics URL. So basically the org, CRM region, and dynamics.com. That's what you put there. And then the client ID, again, if we come back to our app registration, is just going to be this application ID here. Then we just need to put in our secret. So grab that from Azure. You will need to copy that when it's created, because that's the only time you're able to see it. And we're ready to go. So let's go ahead and run this flow and populate our calendar items, our holiday calendar for 2025. One more thing I will note, in this apply to each loop, I have turned off concurrency control. Reason being, when I first tested this out, I had concurrency turned on and the flow said it ran successfully, but it only created 3 items, even though I was expecting 12. When I turned it off, it worked. So I suspect I was just hitting this endpoint too quickly. All right, let's go ahead and test this out. Test. And away we go. So we can see our flow started running. We've gone to the API, we've filtered our array, and we're in the process of creating these in Dataverse. And it looks like our flow has finished running. Cool. So let's pop over to Dataverse. Let's refresh this view. And you can see we've got our 2025 holidays that have been created in customer service using this endpoint. Very, very cool. Now, we're not quite ready to take this to production. Let me show you why. So if I click edit again, and let's just go ahead and rerun this flow. Wait for this to run real quick. Those of you playing along at home can probably guess what's about to happen. There we go, the flow's run. Let's come back to our calendar, do a quick refresh. And as you can see, we've doubled up our holidays. Now, I don't know about you, I think the idea of having two Christmases is awesome, but the reality is when we're trying to accurately compute things like SLAs, this could be a problem. So let me flick over to my mural board and let me show you some changes that I would make before this is ready to productionize. All right, so let me just zoom in here. So what would I do? Well, firstly, we need to change our trigger to be a scheduled flow, have it run once a year, say 1st of June, something like that. Next, what I would do is I would list all of the holiday wrapper rows for that year, i.e. 2025. So I come in and say, find all the holidays for 2025. And I would do a compose on those results. And basically, if the length equals the expected number of holidays, so for the example here in Auckland, we have 12 a year. So if we found 12 holidays for 2025, go ahead and terminate the flow. We don't need to run this. However, if we found less than that, then we can go ahead and we can go through all the rigmarole here of getting our public holidays and filtering our array. However, what I would do is for each holiday, I'd compare it to Dataverse. So I would say, do we have an Auckland Anniversary Day? Do we have a Boxing Day? Do we have a Christmas Day, et cetera? And if we find the holiday, skip it, otherwise create it. That way, if we've only got a handful that have been created, say somebody came in and manually created Boxing Day but didn't do the rest of them, we can create 11. If there's none there, we can create all 12. So that's how I would, those are some of the changes that I would make to this flow to productionize it. But in the meantime, that is how you automatically create holidays in Dynamics 365 customer service using Power Automate. Again, there's a great API using Worldwide Bank Holidays in the Power Platform. Simply filter your array and then use a post to the Save Holiday endpoint in Dataverse, and this will work for you. Shout out again to Ben Clist. Thanks so much, mate. You are awesome. This solved a massive issue for me, and I am so thrilled. Thanks all for watching. Go do something awesome on the Power Platform today, and I'll talk to you all soon.